Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. New reports in popular science media highlight some of the theoretical limitations in planetary science and geology today. Limitations which have resulted in countless mysteries related to planets, moons, and comets. The reports in question propose that volcanism on various bodies throughout the solar system is more pervasive than scientists have ever previously believed, even supposedly occurring on comets. On March 6, 2017, astronomy.com published the article, "Planetary Scientists Are Turning Up Volcanoes Everywhere They Look." The report focuses heavily on a theoretical phenomenon called cryovolcanism, or ice volcanoes. On planet Earth, scientists theorize that the shifting of tectonic plates is the cause of both earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. But on several other worlds which are not thought to have plate tectonics, planetary scientists believe they observe another type of volcanism called cryovolcanism. A cryovolcano, or ice volcano, is hypothesized to result when gravitational forces produce tidal heating and other effects in an icy body, producing volcanic eruptions. For decades, planetary scientists have believed that tidal heating is the cause of the most dramatic volcanism in our entire solar system, on the Jovian moon Io. The astronomy.com article outlines the hypothesis as follows. Io and other Galilean satellites, such as Europa and Ganymede, are in synchronous rotation around Jupiter. Io then becomes caught up in a tug of war between Jupiter's gravity and the gravity of these other satellites. This in turn leads to the bulging of Io's crust up and down, and the resulting friction produces a large amount of heat and a molten interior. When the pressure builds, it occasionally erupts melted rock and plumes of gas. However, as previously reported on this series, observations in recent years have effectively falsified the tidal heating model for Io's so-called volcanoes. In 2013, a geological survey found that the surprising locations of the plumes, quote, can't be reconciled with any existing solid body tidal heating model. But the problems for the volcano hypothesis on Io began almost immediately after their discovery. In fact, in 1979, it was the world-renowned astrophysicist Thomas Gold who first proposed that Io's so-called volcanic plumes were in fact high-energy electrical discharges. 9 years later, plasma scientist Anthony Peratt of Los Alamos Laboratories and co-author Alex Dessler also proposed an electrical mechanism for the, quote, plumes. If the plumes are in fact electrical discharges, this would account for numerous anomalies with the standard hypothesis, including their filamentary structure, a completely anomalous feature for any volcanic plume, as well as their surprising movements across the surface of Io. But perhaps most significantly, the electrical interpretation explains the electrical currents that have been found connecting the Jovian atmosphere and its icy moons. Planetary scientists insist that the source of the electrical currents is charged particles from volcanic eruptions. But this hypothesis was complicated when scientists also found the auroral footprints of the moons Europa and Ganymede. A research team wrote of this discovery, "Europa is not thought to be volcanic, so what could produce the electrical current that zips along and eventually gives rise to Europa's auroral footprint?" Similar problems also face planetary scientists who seek to explain the high-velocity features seen jetting from the Saturnian moon Enceladus. More than a decade ago, the discovery of the enormous jets and plumes at Saturn's south pole astonished scientists working on NASA's Cassini mission. Scientists had expected the moon to be geologically dead, and the last place they expected such activity would be the moon's south pole. As reported by space.com at the time, the finding flipped everything scientists knew about Enceladus on its head, because what should have been a dead moon appeared to be geologically active, and what was supposed to be the moon's coldest region turned out to be its warmest. A co-investigator of the Cassini mission said of the discovery, "This is as astonishing as if we'd flown past Earth and found that Antarctica was warmer than the Sahara." The tiny moon is a mere 504 kilometers in diameter, and the icy plumes were seen to reach up to 480 kilometers high. Investigators settled on the notion that liquid water must be present under the surface like a Yellowstone geyser in order for it to erupt in high-speed jets. A NASA news release stated, "The rare occurrence of liquid water so near the surface raises many questions about this mysterious moon." But the immediate assumption of liquid water near the surface only showed that the surprising discovery caused no reassessment of a theoretical framework. Scientists settled on the notion that Saturn must be, quote, gravitationally kneading Enceladus, producing so-called cryovolcanoes at the moon's south pole through friction heating. In 2015, planetary scientists made the surprising discovery that particles in the Enceladus plumes are electrically charged. A lead investigator studying data from the Cassini plasma spectrometer said of the discovery, "What are particularly fascinating are the bursts of dust that CAPS detects when Cassini passes through the individual jets in the plume. Each jet is split according to charge, though. Negative grains are on one side and positive ones on the other. As in the Jovian system, we see an electrical connection between Saturn and Enceladus." The comparability of the gas giants' respective environments is summarized by Thunderbolt's Picture of the Day managing editor Stephen Smith in his article, "Enceladus is Plugged In." It's easiest to get an idea of what is happening on Enceladus by comparing it to another moon in the solar system, Jupiter's moon Io. Io acts like an electrical generator as it travels through Jupiter's plasma sphere, inducing over 400,000 volts across its diameter and more than 3 million amperes. That tremendous current flows along its magnetic field into the electric environment of Jupiter. The same kind of electromagnetic activity connects Enceladus with Saturn's poles. In the electric universe interpretation, neither the one-way electrical transaction scientists propose, nor the assumed charge neutrality of Jupiter, Saturn, and their respective moons can be valid. The electrical discharge activity that scientists misinterpret as cryovolcanism on Io and Enceladus may be comparable to the filamentary jets of comets, which are also electrical in nature. Ironically, in the March 2017 Astronomy.com report, "Are There Volcanoes on Comets?" the article suggests that so-called volcanic activity has occurred on comet 29P Schwassmann-Vachmann in its orbit between Saturn and Jupiter. It states, "The strange activity may be due to the comet's unusually long day-night cycle. Unlike most comets, which rotate on hourly scales, 29P rotates only about once every 60 Earth days. During the comet's long night, material may pool in chambers beneath the surface. When the comet rotates into its long day, the gas expands, flexing the surface. High pressures can help the gas break through the surface, exploding outward in a volcano-like event. Instead of hot magma, frozen gas streams from the comet." However, neither the imagined subsurface cometary ice nor the theoretical nozzles from which comet jets supposedly emanate have ever been found. The 2012 paper, "Cometary Jet Collimation Without Physical Confinement," published in the American Geophysical Union, acknowledged the dilemma as follows. "Contemporary models postulate that these jets collimate when the expanding gases and dust pass through a physical aperture or nozzle. However, recent high-resolution spacecraft observations fail to detect such apertures on comet surfaces. Furthermore, these models do not explain why cometary jets appear to be directed normal to the local gravitational potential and/or to originate on the faces of scarps. In fact, electrical discharges producing comet jets on the faces of scarps is a prediction of the electric comet theory, which states that electrical activity will always center on the sharp points of a body, which act as kinds of lightning rods. Yet today, consensus scientific theory remains that comets are slowly sublimating ice balls that produce outbursts or sometimes disintegrate due to increasingly strange processes. In the electric universe theory, a comet's activity is the result of its experiencing voltage spikes in its changing plasma environment. One of the most promising yet still overlooked pathways of discovery is the growing evidence for a link between cometary outbursts and dramatic solar activity. At the 2016 Thunderbolts Project conference, "Elegant Simplicity," Russian scientist Dr. Supan Ibadov presented the talk, "Nature of Electric Comets, Electric Discharge Mechanism of Comet Outbursts, and Thunderbolts Lightning in Comet Nuclei Due to Solar Flares." On the planet Mars, recent discoveries may provide a clue to the electrical phenomena that planetary scientists sometimes interpret as volcanism. In 2012, amateur astronomers spotted enormous plumes jetting from the Martian surface. The plumes were more than 250 kilometers high and several hundreds of kilometers in length. Similar bright, enormous plumes have occasionally been spotted on Mars since 1997, leaving astronomers completely baffled. However, In 2016, scientists reported that a dramatic appearance of the plumes occurred immediately after Mars was hit by a coronal mass ejection. In standard reasoning, there is no reason why charged particles from the Sun would produce such a dramatic dust-raising event. As one scientist stated, it's very surprising that was affecting Mars right before the plume was first observed. A new scientist report on the discovery acknowledged the unavoidability of an electrical interpretation. It stated, "One possibility is that plasma could be interacting with ice grains or dust lower down in the atmosphere and electrically charging them, boosting them higher, but it's not clear how the effect would be big. It's surely no coincidence that the Martian plumes appear strikingly similar in structure to the plumes on the moons Io and Enceladus. Perhaps the single greatest obstacle in the space sciences is the ongoing assumption of charge neutrality for celestial objects. On our own Earth, scientists are still making extraordinary discoveries, completely unexpected in standard theory, confirming our planet's dynamic electrical environment. This includes the recent discovery of, quote, supersonic plasma jets high up in our atmosphere that can push temperatures up to almost 10,000 degrees Celsius. A phys.org report on the finding, which will be the topic of a forthcoming Space News episode, states, the theory that there are huge electric currents, powered by solar wind and guided through the ionosphere by Earth's magnetic field, was postulated more than a century ago by Norwegian scientist Christian Birkeland. While much is known about these current systems, recent observations by the ESA's Swarm mission have revealed that they are associated with large electrical fields. If our own Earth still presents such mysteries for institutional science, what further surprises might distant worlds still hold? Moreover, how many ongoing mysteries will finally be resolved when space scientists abandon the notion of an electrically sterile and disconnected universe? For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.